Hello student, in this video we will start another article in unit number 4. The name of the article is Effect of Granularity on Performance. So this is the third article, Effects of Granularity on the Performance. In the previous video we completed sources of overhead in parallel program, performance metrics for parallel system. We discussed the two main performance metrics, that is the speed up and efficiency, along with the parallel time TP. We consider two examples to understand this analytical modeling of parallel programs, that is adding n numbers on n processor and sorting the numbers using bubble sort and quick sort. So dear students, today we will start our third article of this unit, that is Effect of Granularity on Performance. Now dear students, remember the example of adding n numbers on n processor. In that example, an instance of algorithm that explain is not cost optimal. Now in the previous video I already covered what is mean by cost. I will repeat it once again. So the cost of solving a problem on parallel system is a product of parallel runtime and the number of processing element used. So cost is nothing but the product of parallel runtime and the number of processing elements which are used to solve that program or problem. That is the cost. Cost sometimes also referred as work or processor time product, and cost optimal system is also known as PTP optimal system. Okay, adding n numbers on n processor is a not cost optimal algorithm. So that is we are mentioning here to start this effect of granularity on performance. You remember that adding n numbers on n processor algorithm is not cost optimal. The algorithm discussed in this section or in this example, that is adding n numbers on n processor, uses as many processing element as the number of inputs, which is excessive in terms of number of processing element. Now in practice we assign larger piece of input data to processing element. Okay, so this is a very centralized concept of this adding n numbers on n processor, that what we are doing there. I will repeat, this algorithm uses many processing element as the number of inputs, which is excessive in terms of number of processing element. So in practice we assign larger piece of input data to processing element. This corresponds to increasing the granularity of computation on processing element. So using fewer than maximum possible number of processing element to execute a parallel algorithm is called scaling down a parallel system in terms of number of processing element. Okay, now a navy way to scale down a parallel system is to design a parallel algorithm for one input element per processing element and then use a fewer processing element to simulate a large number of processing element. How it can be done? So see here, if there are n inputs and only p processing element, p is less than n, we can use a parallel algorithm designed for n processing element by assuming n virtual processing element and having each of the p physical processing element simulate n by p virtual processing element. As the number of processing element decreases by a factor of n by p, the computation at each processing element increases by a factor of n by p, because each processing element now perform the work of n by p processing element. If virtual processing elements are mapped appropriately onto physical processing element, The overall communication time does not grow by more than a factor of n by p. The total parallel runtime increases at most by a factor of n by p, and the processor time product does not increase. Therefore, if a parallel system with n processing element is cost optimal, using p processing element where p is less than n to simulate n processing element preserve cost optimability or optimality. A drawback of this Navy method of increasing the computational granularity is that if a parallel system is not cost optimal to begin with, it may still not be cost optimal after granularity of computation increases. Okay, so this is the topic that we are going to learn today. I already covered many things. I will again repeat it. Effect of granularity on performance. Dear student, what happened? Often a fewer processor improves the performance of parallel system. Using fewer than maximum possible number of processing element to execute a parallel algorithm is called as scaling down the parallel system. A Navy way of scaling down is to think of each processor in the original case as a virtual processor and to assign the virtual processor equally to scale down processor. Since the number of processing element decreases by factor of n by p, the computation at each processing element increases by n by p. The computation cost should not increase by this factor, since some of the virtual processor assigned to physical processor might talk to each other. This is the basic reason for improvement from building granularity. Now, consider the example of building the granularity. See which example we are considering here. So adding n number on n processing element. Consider the problem of adding n number on p processing element such that p is less than n and both n and p are power of 2. So consider the problem of adding n number on n processing element such that p is less than n and both n and p are the power of 2. So we use the same algorithm as example in the previous example in the previous video and simulate n processing element on p processing element. So step leading to solution are shown in the figure. This figure is available here. See, this is the figure actually. Okay, so figure shows for n equal to 16 and p is equal to 4. Okay, so 16 numbers are there and 4 processors are there. So virtual processing element I is simulated by physical processing element labeled I mod p. The numbers to added are distributed similarly. The first log p of log n steps of original algorithm are simulated in n by p log p steps on p processing element. In the remaining steps, no communication is required because the processing element that communicate in the original algorithm are simulated by the same processing element. Hence, the remaining numbers are added locally. The algorithm takes big O of n by p log p time in the steps that requires communication, after which the processing element, single processing element, is left with n by p numbers to add, taking time big O of n by p. Thus, the overall parallel execution time of this parallel system is big O of n by p log p. Okay, so dear student, if you see, we are considering the same problem of adding n numbers on n processing element where p is less than n. Okay, we use the parallel algorithm for n processor, except in this case we think of them as a virtual processor. Each of the p processor is now assigned n by p virtual processor. First log p of the log n step of the original algorithm are simulated in n by p log p step on p processing element. Subsequent log n log p steps do not require any communication. The overall parallel execution time of this parallel system is big O n by p log p. The cost is big O n log p, which is asymptotically higher than big O of n cost of adding n numbers subsequently. Therefore, the parallel system is not cost optimal. Now, building the granularity, this example is continued here, can be build granularity in the example in the cost optimal fashion. So each processing element locally adds its n by p numbers in time big O n by p. The p partial sum of p processing element can be added in time big O n by p as shown in this figure c. And after that, we get a granularity, that is parallel runtime of this algorithm, is pp big O n by p plus log p, where n is equal to omega p log p big O. The cost is big O n plus p log p. So this is cost optimal so long as. So this is the effect of granularity on the performance. So we can make a non-cost optimal algorithm into a cost optimal algorithm by using the granularity. So here we are scaling down the number of processor so that we can increase the performance. Okay, so that is the aim of this article, effect of granularity on performance. I hope that you have understood all these things. Okay, now we will stop here. And in the next lecture, we will see one more very important concept, that is scalability of the parallel system. Till then, goodbye. Thank you very much.